Chancellor, congratulations. I must say that there is so much excitement around your appointment. And I'm talking about from teachers that I know individually, parents, educators, just up and down the line. And the excitement that I always hear is they say, most of them say two things to me. They say, one, you're a solutionist and not an obstructionist. And as many people will tell you, there are times when individuals get into position of authorities, especially in government, and they feel as though their job is only to tell you what you can't do and how they know that you can't do it. But I've heard just the opposite of you, that you are always trying to figure out solutions. Obviously, Senator Velmanette has an intimate relationship with you, and she knows you for quite some time, and so she has clearly educated me around all that you do. All that you
can. Velmanette, can I tell you around take you around the city with me?
So my concern is, as I know many are talking about, pre-K and vocational training and all that is good. My focus is more on the tools that our young people need to be using to make them competitive with those that are in China and India and all around. The governor has what I consider to be a very considerable program, that Smart School program. That's a $2 billion program. Many are not paying attention to that, but that's a tremendous amount of money. And it's going to be a tremendous amount of resources that's going to be put in place, that's going to be spread around our schools. Now, I spoke to the commissioner of the State Department of Education. He testified earlier. He said they were still working out how that program might function, what their plans are for it. My question to you is, are there any discussions between you and the State Department of Education? Because when that money does become available, obviously it's statewide, but you know New York City school system, a million or so students. I can tell you, and I hate to be so graphically aggressive, but in Southeast Queens, it's almost like a Mason-Dixon line in terms of when you go across the Van Wyck or Hillside Avenue,
absolutely,
the schools change dramatically. The tools that they utilize change dramatically. So I'm just curious as to whether or not they've started talking to you about it, and if not, I hope they will. In your solutionist role, I hope that you will involve parents and teachers and students in terms of what type of equipment they purchase, because we already experienced Common Core when there was lack of participation, and we would hope that we wouldn't go down that road with the Smart School program.
Well, we haven't had that conversation yet. I don't want to keep saying to you 3.5. I mean, I met him for the first time yesterday, and we did talk a little bit. But to me, the most important thing about the program that you're talking about is that when I go to middle schools that have smart boards, for example, the learning comes alive because teachers can use, again, it's training the teachers to use the tools that support not having the tool, because you can go to a school and you can see a tool and it's just sitting there. So how do we train the teachers to use smart boards, for example, to make the learning come alive? I was in a middle school in the Bronx where they were actually doing The Prince by Machiavelli, which I didn't get till I was in my master's program. And the kids were actually dialoguing with the smart board and the actors talking to each other. So I think, and besides, our adolescents learn through technology. They're wired to technology. My grandchildren are wired to technology. I'm the one who really is out of the loop. So I do think the conversation is important. I also believe that middle school kids in particular should have access to iPads and other things. So I do think when we get to that point of discussion, I really will have a plan. And I think it's also another great way to use telecommunications. We're getting teachers. You don't have to take teachers out of their schools to do professional development. Right. You can actually have teachers listening to the programs that where they're being instructed by staying in their own school site, which also saves us money and time. And a lot more countries, Canada, because of their vast geographical area, does almost all their professional development through telecommunications. So I think there's a lot of ways to use technology. And once I find out what our fair share of it is, I will certainly make sure that I get it.
All right. Well, thank you, Commissioner. And we stand ready to support you in that effort.